WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Are you a singer, a musician, or a producer? Are you looking to record a demo, a song, or an entire album? This is Angela Harden, General Manager of WHCR 90.3 FM, and I'm excited to tell you that you no longer have to travel all the way downtown to record your project. WHCR offers a state-of-the-art recording studio with an experienced engineer. Our studio is affordably priced and conveniently located in the heart of Harlem, right here on the campus of City College. For rates and information, please call 212-650-7147. That's 212-650-7147. Harlem has its own radio station and its own recording studio.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Good evening and welcome to Black Beat New York. My name is Flo Wiley and I am delighted to be here with you one more week telling you some of the things that I know of that are going on in the arts. For those of you tuning in for the very first time, welcome to Black Beat New York, where we talk about everything arts, and I play you some of the music that I love because I just can't get enough of it. That's all it is. And I want to welcome those of you who are listening from all over the world. I miss not being here last week. I missed being able to tell you some of the things that were going on in the sweet village of Harlem as Mother Nature took her best shot at us and wreaked some havoc here and there. But I am glad to be back. I'm glad that the station survived intact and that there are some stories of victory amidst all of the chaos. It is a good time to be alive always. Every day that you draw breath is a good one. And we pray for improved quality of life for all of our sisters and brothers, all of the families, mothers, fathers, children, all of the individuals that were impacted by and continue to be impacted by the continuing environmental challenges to our way of life and to all of the bureaucratic snafus. Help is on the way. Help is on the way. I've got some news coming up a little bit later on about some of the things you can do if you're looking to help out at all. I've got a couple of places that you can check in and see where you might be able to offer your services, because help is on the way in the form of various guises. So thank you very much for keeping it right here at WHCR 90.3 FM, Harlem Community Radio. We're delighted to have your support. Black Beat New York has been on the air for 11 years. Can you believe it? Thanksgiving Sunday will be 11 years, and I still walk in here saying, okay, now what do I do? Well, that's all right. I'm working it out every moment, and I thank you for continuing to listen. The last time I was here, I was talking about with Michael Henderson about a concert that he was to have done on Friday, November 2nd with Lynette McKee. That concert has been rescheduled. It is now going to take place on Friday, November 30th. And I will be reminding you of that as this week and next week and the week after to make sure that you don't miss this exciting evening of entertainment at Aaron Davis Hall, Convent Avenue and 135th Street, a night to remember Lynette McKee and Michael Henderson with Miles Davis band members. I may have to play some of that interview that I did with him because we really had a good time and we gave away the tickets and all of the ticket holders have been informed about the change in date. It's now Friday, November 30th. So look for more information. Lynette McKee and Michael Henderson, A Night to Remember, rescheduled. Thank you to all of you who voted. It did my heart so good to look out the window and see those lines stretch down the block the same way they were 4 years ago. I'm proud of my community. I'm really, really very proud the way we turned out, and we were patient and we hung in there despite all of the many snafus. We hung in there and voted and made sure that our vote counted. And I'm very, very happy with that having happened. With I believe in democracy, and at the cornerstone of it is one man, one vote, one human, one vote. So thank you for doing that. I wanted to tell you that I went to the African Diaspora Film Festival press event just before the storm hit. I went last Friday. And there's some great films that they are going to show at this year's film festival. Really, really, really awesome films celebrating their 20-year. So I'll be having them come on the air next week because they open on the 23rd of December of November and run until the 11th of December. They've sent me some films, so I'm going to get a chance to look at the whole film of some of them instead of just the trailers that we saw at the press event. But I'm very impressed with the quality of the work that they're doing and the whole all of the different countries represented in their work. They had films on Jews in Nigeria, Igbos who are Jews who are in Nigeria and talking back about the historic reemergence of the Jews of Nigeria. There was the Garifuna, a film about the Garifuna continuing the dignity of keeping up that language. And there were just so many, many. And then a lovely 17-minute film by a City College graduate, Samian Priester, I believe is the way you pronounce his name, looking at fatherhood in the lives of many men in Harlem. He did it in 2011. It's a little short, 16, 17-minute film, but powerful. It really, really does leave you with something. It really, really does. So those are some, some of the things that I've been doing since I was here, and I've been working hard on my anniversary party. I'm celebrating the 11th anniversary, 11 years of Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show, on Friday, November 23rd from 10 p.m. until 2 a.m. with a Black Friday dance party, baby. Yes. At Gran Piazza de Oro at 5th Avenue and 117th Street. I'm asking you to dress up. Yes, baby. Put on your holiday finery, your holiday glamour, your holiday festive. Put it all on and come out and let's look good and have a great, great time together. If you want some more information about that, please send me your email address at blackbeatnewyork@whcr.org. That's blackbeatnewyork@whcr.org. If you are a listener that does not have an email address and you still want to come to this party, then when I am playing some music this evening, call me while I'm here in the station and I will get your address and I will figure out how to get you some information. The number here in the studio is 212-650-6903, 212-650-6903. Just write that number down somewhere and call me when I'm playing some music, which I'm getting ready to do right now. That was Onaji Allen Gums playing earlier. Try to Remember was the name of that track. It's from his CD, Sack Full of Dreams, from which I'm going to play the title cut. Wonderful song with Akin Oba Babatunde, called him by his brother's name, singing on that. I'll play that later on. But right now, I want to play some Alan Harris. He's got a new CD called Convergence, and it's Alan Harris, vocalist, and Takana Miyamoto is the pianist. She's on piano. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful CD. And he's often at Smoke, you know, over on the west side at 106th Street and down at the Manhattan Center. He's all over town. He was at the Olympics. He's a wonderful human being. and such a great singer. So here's a little bit of Alan Harris for your listening pleasure. Now I'll come back and tell you about some of the things going on in the world of the arts in the sweet village of Harlem and throughout the fabulous New York City. You are listening to Black Beat New York, The Flo Wiley Show.
Love is funny, or it's sad, or it's quiet, or it's mad. It's a good thing, or it's bad, but beautiful. Beautiful to take a chance, and if you fall, you fall. And I'm thinking I wouldn't mind at all. Love is tearful, or it's gay. It's a problem, or it's play. It's a heartache either way, but beautiful. And I'm thinking, if you were mine, I'd never let you go. And that would be but beautiful, I know.
I get misty just holding your hand. That music I hear, I get misty the moment you're near. You can say knowing my right foot from my left, my hat from my glove. I'm too misty and too much in love. I'm just too misty and too
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
What a lovely, lovely voice. You almost just don't want to say anything when Sarah Vaughan is singing. You just want to let the notes come as they will. I was on the phone during that break with Rome Neal. He's going to be doing his one-man show, Monk. So I'll be telling you some information about that in a minute. So hang on. He's going to be doing it at Rustic's Tavern out in Brooklyn. He was calling to tell me that I could not be seen on the cameras. All right? So I have fixed that. I can now be seen. And now I have an interview on the radio. Let me see here. I've been gone a week. Let's see if I can remember how to bring the brother on. You are on the air. Welcome to Black Beat New York. Are you there?
I'm here. Thank you.
Yes. I mean, you have no idea. I've only been doing this forever, but sometimes when I'm away for a few days, it kind of has its moment with me. So, welcome to Black Beat New York. I'm delighted to have you on. You are with Opera Ebony, that is correct?
Yes, that's correct.
I remember Opera Ebony from back in the day, and I was delighted to hear that you all are back. So,
Yes. Tell
me about your return and how it's going to be. I know you have a concert next weekend Aaron Davis Hall here, the beautifully, acoustically perfect Aaron Davis Hall.
That's correct.
And you're presenting a very interesting program for an opera company. So Tell me first, introduce who you are, what you have to do with it. Talk about what's going to happen at your program next week. And then we'll talk a little bit about what's next for Opera Ebony. So thank you for calling in.
Thank you very much. My name is Gregory Shepherd, and I am the new general manager of Opera Ebony. I was appointed to this position just this past August.
Uh-huh.
And next weekend at Aaron Davis Hall on November 16th, the company actually opens its 40th anniversary season.
Wow.
Opera Ebony was established in 1973.
I think I was around then. I do. I'm trying to remember the name of the man that was the face of Opera Ebony for 100 years. But go on. Tell us about next Friday's program.
Yeah, next Friday night, we open the season with a performance called Sass and Class.
Mm.
And it's interesting and unique to open an operatic season with something that actually is not an opera.
I'm so glad you said that because I did find that interesting.
Yeah, what we have here is a compilation of jazz and popular music.
Okay.
The music of George Gershwin, Duke Ellington, Candor Ebb, Ray Henderson.
These are called can't-miss classics.
Yes, exactly. And what this is, the music director and founder, Wayne Sanders, has tied all of this together and woven a story about love and relationship, romance. It involves 10 singers, not a full orchestra, but we have wonderful Randolph Noel on piano, We have a bass player and drums.
Excellent.
And so and we're opening the season with this production because the company did it back in 2006 at the Metropolitan Museum of Art, and it was a huge success.
Great.
And it was repeated the following season at Merkin Concert Hall and also in Martinique. And
excellent.
Wayne and I thought that it would be interesting to open the season with this to show the public what else
yes.
trained opera singers can do.
Yes.
Because we can do more than just sing opera.
Yes.
And also it's a way of developing an audience, you know, get people into the theater, hear these classical singers singing popular music, singing jazz. Hopefully they'll come back.
That would be the plan. Yes.
Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Well, I think it's a great plan. I really do. I think making the music accessible by virtue of first exposing the audience to the voices and the personalities
yes.
and the whole sense of the love of music is a wonderful way to then segue into, now here's what our wheelhouse really looks like.
Right. And we get some opera in there because there is some Mozart, there's some Purcell,
mm-hmm.
there's Gilbert and Sullivan.
Excellent.
Infused and woven into all of this.
Excellent, excellent. I am delighted that Opera Ebony is back. And Wayne, who you mentioned, was the living, breathing embodiment of Opera Ebony forever.
Still.
So I'm delighted that he, yes, that still
yes.
is the word I was going to, that
yes.
he is still involved.
Absolutely.
So now this is going to be next Friday
yes.
at Aaron Davis Hall. At what time?
7:30 p.m.
And how will people get information? We're not in the business of selling tickets here on
mm-hmm.
this non-commercial radio, but
right,
I would
right.
like people to know how to get more information about this event. So where
sure,
will they go?
Sure, they can go online to Aaron Davis Hall's website, which is www.adh@ccny.org.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Or call the box office, 212-650-6900.
And what if they want to know more about Opera Ebony?
Opera Ebony has a website, www.operaebony.org.
Couldn't be easier.
Yeah, and the opening page of this site is all about Fast and Class.
Oh, good, because we at the radio station have the fastest growing part of our listenership is our online listenership. So I want to always make sure that I make that resource available to my listeners.
Excellent.
So they can go on and find out about operaebony.org.
Yes.
And while they're there, they can find out about the concert next Friday and then also about the things that you all will be doing henceforth.
Yes.
Right, because I know you got to be. What is the next? Are you having a holiday program?
We are not having a holiday program. Our next performance after this is actually during Black History Month.
Okay.
And so we have two events planned during that month. We have a heritage concert, which is all music of
uh-huh.
African-American composers. And
excellent.
It's spirituals, art songs, arias of African-American composers.
Wonderful.
And then we're also doing something which I think is very interesting. We're having a master class. We're going to
see
five young upcoming singers and a master teacher. We haven't settled on who that's going to be yet. We're in talks with some people, and that's going to be open to the public. And it's about the experience of singing
yeah.
classical music of African American composers, spiritual
and the process of
yes.
mastering it. Yeah,
yes, exactly. And what that performance art is all about.
That's awesome.
So that's
a great idea.
A public performance.
That's
and
also
all of that takes
another
place
way
on the same weekend.
Now, which is when?
November 9th and 10th, the master class, February
9th.
February 9th.
And 10th.
And February 10th is the concert.
And you will again, you are in residence at Aaron Davis Hall, I understand.
We are in residence at Aaron
right.
Davis Hall. That concert actually isn't going to be at Aaron Davis. That will be at the Church of St. Paul and St. Andrew on West 86th Street. And then we're back at Aaron Davis Hall in April for a big operatic celebration of Giuseppe Verdi and Georges Bizet, and the celebration of the 40th anniversary of Opera Ebony.
Excellent. I'm
yeah.
so glad to hear all of this. My good
thank
friend,
you.
Femi, with whom I'm working on another project, she, when I was talking to her about this, she says, well, you know, I'm with Opera Ebony. And I was like, yeah.
yes,
you know,
she is our production manager.
Yes, and she is the production manager to have if you want to have a flawless production.
Yes.
Most definitely. So I want to thank you, Gregory Shepherd, for calling in, the new GM of Opera Ebony.
It was a pleasure.
And to talk about your program. I understand now why when I asked for some music, they said that there wasn't any music available. I get it now. Because I always like to play a little music to hype up interest in the thing. Yes. But next week when I talk about it again, maybe let's see how your things are going. And maybe you can give me a pair of tickets that I can give away next
Absolutely.
Week.
Absolutely.
I don't want to give them away
I make
week.
That promise to you right now.
Oh, okay. That's great. That's great. I'm going to have a ticket giveaway week next week because I've got your tickets. I'll have another pair of tickets to the concert, another concert at Aaron Davis Hall. And then I think Adelko has given me a pair of tickets. So it's going to be a big giveaway week next Thursday.
Wonderful.
So thank you for calling in to talk to us about this wonderful event and this outstanding, long-standing cultural institution here in the sweet village of Harlem and in the wonderful city of New York. Opera Ebony. 40 years celebrating.
40 years.
40 years with a concert next Friday, some things happening in February, and then a big blowout in April. Fully celebrating the 40th. So once again, operaebony.org. You have and the phone number for the box office at Aaron Davis is 212-650-6900, I believe.
That's correct.
Yeah, okay, great. Wonderful. So thank you for calling in to talk to us, and I will be in touch with your person about the tickets that I'll give away next week.
Absolutely.
All right, thank you.
Thank
you. Take care. God bless.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show here on WHCR 90.3 FM. Figure out how to cancel the call, child. There you go. And just talking with Gregory Shepherd, the new GM of Opera Ebony. That sounds like a really fun concert that they're going to have next week. I think that's going to be fun. I love good singing. I really, really love good singing. And on that note, let me play for you one of my favorite singers, the one and only, the magnificent Miss Billie Holiday. You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show here on WHCR 90.3 FM. Here's Billie.
In my solitude,
could be so sad with
in my solitude, I'm praying, dear Lord above, send me back my love.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
Are you a singer, a musician, or a producer? Are you looking to record a demo, a song, or an entire album? This is Angela Harden, General Manager of WHCR 90.3 FM, and I'm excited to tell you that you no longer have to travel all the way downtown to record your project. WHCR offers a state-of-the-art recording studio with an experienced engineer. Our studio is affordably priced and conveniently located in the heart of Harlem, right here on the campus of City College. For rates and information, please call 212-650-7147. That's 212-650-7147. Harlem has its own radio station and its own recording studio.
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
You're listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show here on WHCR 90.3 FM. I'm delighted to be here with you. I really, really am. I want to thank you for tuning in to listen to Black Beat New York, whether you are tuning in and listening to me on the radio waves or whether you are listening on your computer, your phone, your laptop, however your tablet you are managing to bring in this program, I want to thank you. Whether you are in the sweet village of Harlem, in the wonderful New York City, any of the five boroughs of this great metropolis, or you are listening live online from somewhere else in the world, thank you for tuning in to Black Beat New York. I want to get to what is essentially, ostensibly, I should say, the crux of what we do here, which is to tell you about things going on in the world of the arts. And I'm going to put on a little Miles Davis underneath me while I talk to you about this. So here we go. I'm going to play it so I can hear it. I'm sure hoping you can hear it because I see that it's playing. And let you know what is going on. Yeah, it's going on. Great. That's Miles Davis. My French is non-existent. Fil de Kilimanjaro. I think that's what it's F-I-L-L-E-S. That means girls of Kilimanjaro, women of Kilimanjaro, something like that. With his one of his later groups, Miles, Wayne Shorter, Chick Corea, Dave Holland, and Tony Williams on drums. Anyway, that's going to play for a little while. While it plays, I get to tell you about some things that are going on. I mentioned to you that Rome Neal called, and he's going to be doing his one-man show, Monk, which was written by Lawrence Holder. It's going to be Sundays at 4 o'clock for the next month, a month of Sundays at 4 o'clock at the Rustic Tavern, R-U-S-T-I-K Tavern, 471 DeKalb Avenue in the borough of Brooklyn. The 4 o'clock on Sundays, the number for you to call to get more information is 718-288-8048. That's 718-288-8048. You can always find Rome on Facebook as well. Also wanted to tell you that for those of you that are interested in helping out, especially in Far Rockaway, a community that has been hurt, severely damaged with the loss of a lot of things. On next Saturday, this Saturday rather, November 10th, wait a minute. Yeah, that's Saturday, November 10th. From 9 a.m. until 3 p.m., there will be crews helping to clean houses and blocks and delivering goods to those who cannot come out, and holding a motivational, informational teach-in. This comes from Erica Ford by way of April Silver. You know, April loves to get the word out. And Far Rock is very special to her. So the purpose of this is obvious, okay? They need things for Saturday. They need bikes. They need iPads to help people fill out these lovely FEMA applications. Chairs and tables, heaters, a list of things. Cars, trucks, power packs, charging stations, brooms, shovels, masks, work gloves, whatever, generators, flashlights. Those are things they need to help with the giveaway. I mean, with the cleanup. Now, to give away, they're looking for batteries, power packs, new cold weather clothing, new cold weather clothing, no more used clothing, sweatshirts, hoodies, fleece jackets. It's cold out there. You know what I'm saying? Gloves, scarves, socks, all weather boots, new. And for the children, some books, some games, some toys, some books, some games, some toys. For the kids, something to occupy their mind so that they don't have to think about the conditions and circumstances around them. And then, of course, supplies, basics like toilet paper and paper towels and garbage bags and cleaning products and baby diapers and baby wipes and anything non-perishable on the food line. So if you're interested in going out to Far Rockaway to help with the cleanup on Saturday, 9 a.m. is the start time for all volunteers. 11 a.m. there's a program that will take place. And then the 3 o'clock, they'll be done. And this is going to be at the Thriftway Strip Mall parking lot, located on Mott Avenue in the Far Rockaway part of Queens, New York. Real easy to get there. Take the A train to the very last stop. Okay, that's where you're going to be, and that's where you need to come out. It's going to be a lot of people there helping to create an environment of love, warmth, and happiness to those devastated by Sandy. I know I am not the only person that finds that name just a little too lightweight for as heavy as it was, wouldn't you say? Yeah, I'm sure you would agree with me. So that's something that's going on that I want you to know about, how you can help out. Now, on the arts scene, oh, and also I wanted to tell you, I knew there was something else. Here in Harlem, there was a meeting last night that was not well attended because, of course, the snowstorm got in the way. At Raw Space, you know, Image Nation Cinema, that's their new space on Adam Clayton Powell in the low 120s, I think, 122nd, I think it might be, right up the street from the Paris Cafe. The Raw Space in Harlem, they are also mobilizing the Harlem community, those who wish to go out and help with Far Rockaway and other places. So if you are of a mind, you could stop by Raw Space or call them and see what you can do to help our brethren and sisterin and fellow men and women, humans in this desperate times. 212-694-2887. 212-694-2887. I applaud your spirit of wanting to help, because that's how we get through it, is we help each other. And you do it because you want to do it. And, you know, not because you don't know that next time might be your turn. You do it because it's the right thing to do. We're here to spread love and to spread joy. Joy is a natural state of being. And if you're not in that joyous state, then something is off. And you don't want to be off. And you don't want to allow off to last for too long. We know how to help each other. We do. It is part of being human. The instinct to help is strong. All right, let me tell you also about something coming up in a couple of weeks. The 40th annual Audelco Viv Awards, Ruby Jubilee, celebrating a 40-year legacy. The Vivian Robinson Audelco Recognition Awards for Excellence in Black Theater takes place on Monday, November 19th at 7 p.m. at the Symphony Space, Peter J. Sharp Theater, Broadway at 95th Street. For more information, you can call this number, 877-771-7772. That's an easy number to remember, 877-771-7772. That will get you some more information about the 40th Viv Award. Special Pioneer recognition will be given to Miss Ruby D. Achievement Awards to Carl Clay of the Black Spectrum Theater in Queens, and to Mickey Grant, who wrote that wonderful Don't Bother Me, I Can't Cope, and to Douglas Turner Ward, one of the founders of the Negro Ensemble Company. Your co-host will be George Faison and Cheryl Wills. I know Cheryl did it last year. I think George might have done it last year too. Anyway, it's Monday, November 19th. Doors open at 6:30. The awards presentation is at 7. There's a meet and greet following it. So that's what's going on with the 40th annual Audelco Viv Awards. They will also be coming on the show next week to talk about what they do. Okay, and who it is that's going to be recognized and all of that. I got a couple more things I got to tell you about, and I promise I'm going to play some more music, okay? Iced Out, Shackled and Chained, Still Looking for the North Star, continues at the National Black Theater, Dr. Barbara Ann Tia's National Black Theater, 2031 Fifth Avenue in Harlem. For it continues through the 18th of November. And here's the number for you to call to get more information about this play, which frames dramatic parallels between slavery and the Jim Crow era with modern day oppression and contemporary impacts of slavery. Yep, that's a mouthful. It's worth checking out. Captivating is what it's been called. 2031 Fifth Avenue in Harlem. That's at 125th Street. 212-722-3800. 212-722-3800. Check out their website to see what the National Black Theater is up to. They are at nationalblacktheater.org. And yes, they spell it theater with an R-E. Woody King Jr.'s New Federal Theater, in association with the Castillo Theater, presents Lonette McKee and Sowa's Red Gravy, which I hear is really funny. I have not gotten down there to see it. It's also starring Keen Holiday and Jonathan Peck and directed by the Dean of Black Theater himself, Mr. Woody King Jr. The Castillo Theater is at 543 West 42nd Street in New York City, and it too plays through the 18th of November. Thursday to Saturday at 7:30, Saturday and Sunday at 2. Kimberly Q, Tony C. Wright, David D. Wright, Iris Wilson, Gary Vincent, and Aaron Freed round out the cast. Castillo Theater, for more information, call this number, 212-941-1234, 212-941-1234, 212-941-1234. And you can also ways find out what Woody King Jr.'s theater is up to by going to their website, newfederaltheater.org, T-H-E-A-T-R-E, again. At the Harlem Arts Alliance meeting on Monday, I saw the wonderfully gifted and talented and so handsome Mr. Ruben Santiago Hudson, who is directing the August Wilson classic, The Piano Lesson, at the Irene Diamond stage of the Signature Theater at the Pershing Square Signature Center on 42nd Street between 9th and 10th Avenues. All the money they spent, then you need to say all of those words because every dime they spent is evident. The fourth play of August Wilson's epic century cycle, The Piano Lesson, is a stunning and moving drama of family, history, and survival. And even as apt as that is, that just begins to scratch the surface of this family story about battling against their surroundings and their shared legacy of an antique piano, which Ruben got a young woman, a sculptor that I met some years ago from White Plains, Vernelle Banieres, who is crafted the relief that is on the piano that is a set piece in this play. So this Pulitzer Prize winning drama is on now, and you can call this number, 212-244-7529. 212-244-7529, or go online to signaturetheater.org for more information. It's featuring Chuck Cooper, Eric Lennox Abrams, Brandon Durden, Jason Durden, Alexis Holt, Mandy Masden, Rosalind Ruff, and James A. Wilson. The Piano Lesson by August Wilson, directed by Ruben Santiago Hudson, at the Irene Diamond stage of the Signature Theater on 42nd Street between 9th and 10th Avenues. I got a few more things to tell you. Big Mac Daddy, the great Mac Daddy, sorry, is back along with some things going on at the Bronx Museum and Dance Theater of Harlem and an Image Nation event that's coming up. I'm going to tell you about that. But right now, before I do anything else, I am going to play some music. This is Onaje Allen Gums and one of my favorite people in the whole wide world, Mr. Oba Babatunde, who is singing for you from Onaje's CD, Sackful of Dreams. This is the title track. You are listening to Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show on WHCR 90.3 FM. Now, as much as I love that, that's really not what I wanted to play. And I really, really do love it, but I'm not going to play that. I want to play Onaje, and I will get around to playing that other thing in a minute when I can.
I've got a dream for the world. Peace in the rivers and everywhere. Bridges of steel and love. And cities that smile. Gray empty faces walk by. Hands try to hide all the loneliness, lighting their cigarettes to blow time away. Lost in the noise, lonely as wind. People on sidewalks with no place to go. Can they learn to understand the kind of world that I'm dreaming? I've got a sack full of dreams. Streets full of laughter and toy balloons. People with hearts that care. Who listen for love. Wanting the same. Wanting to care. Wanting to share all my dreams. For the world, will they learn to understand the world of love that I'm dreaming? Full of dreams. Streets full of laughter and toy balloons. People with hearts that care. Who listen for love. Wanting the same. Wanting to care. Wanting to share all my dreams for the world. Can they learn to understand the world of love
that I am dreaming. The world of love that I am. World of peace, happiness, a world without war and famine. This is my sack full of dreams. Hi, Ma. The world of love that I'm dreaming. My sack full of dreams. Do 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 do
WHCR 90.3 FM, New York.
I don't need to tell you that Quincy Jones and Sarah Vaughan wrote that, right? Oh, that's called Sassy's Blues. What a wonderful, wonderful piece of music. I was running out of time, but I couldn't stop it from playing. You just cannot interrupt a groove that's as good as that. That's from Sarah Vaughan's Finest Hour. And that, of course, Sassy's Blues, written by Quincy Jones and Sarah Vaughan. Wonderful, wonderful piece of work. I got to tell you, that piano player was kicking, was he not? That was Kirk Stewart on piano, Charles Williams on bass, and George Hughes on drums. I got to get out of here, but I need to tell you something before I go, and that is that Opera Ebony is next Friday at 7:30 at Aaron Davis Hall, and Lynette McKee and Michael Henderson are Friday, November 30th at Aaron Davis Hall. And my party, the Black Friday Dance Party, celebrating the 11th anniversary of Black Beat New York, the Flo Wiley Show, is Friday, November 30th from 10 p.m. until 2 a.m. at Gran Piazza d'Oro on 5th Avenue at 117th Street here in the Sweet Village of Harlem. DJ Oh So Cool will spin. There will be a special late night menu that you can purchase, and there will be door prizes to the hottest holiday events. You can hold me to that one. And there's a free beverage with every ticket. So if you would like to get more information about this, then you need to holler at your girl, Flo, at flowiley.com. Real easy, Flo at flowiley.com. Let me know what I can do for you. Until then, until next week, by the grace of God, I'll be right back here. You see that you can do the same. Here's a little something to celebrate how good we can be and how good we have to be to each other.
But now, what makes the world go round? The ups and downs are carousels. Changing people's heads around. Go underground, young man. People make the make the world go round.
Mm-hmm. Wall Street and losing dough on every shade. They're blaming it on longer hair. Yeah. Beeping, smoking in the easy chair. On a fancy car without a care.
world.